friends, and welcome to this special edition of the Jackrabbit Insider. I'm Tyler Merriam, and it is great to have you with us. And this week's show is a special one for me, as it's one of those pots of gold at the end of the proverbial rainbow. Over the last few years, we at the Jackrabbit Sports Network have spent thousands of hours amassing a video archive, but there was always a significant chunk missing. Beginning in the 1970s, South Dakota Public Television would air tape-delayed telecasts of SDSU basketball and football games on Saturday nights throughout the state. Unfortunately, these broadcasts were not saved. In fact, save for a few clips here or there, all were thought to be lost. But then, a stroke of luck. With the help of Phil Jorgensen, who actually plays in the game you are about to see, we have uncovered the full telecast of the 1981 SDSU North Dakota men's basketball game, never seen since it originally aired almost 35 years ago. Two legendary broadcasters, Tom Maxwell and Jim Thompson, are on the call, so enjoy this classic, the 1981 SDSU-UND men's basketball game from January 24th, 1981, inside Frost Arena.
A minute 40 seconds into the game.
Markin averaging 13 points a game. Fossen 19.3. He's the leading scorer for the Sioux.
Sioux will play sagging man-to-man against the Jackrabbits. Winsenburg, 22 points, good. Ron Winsenburg, who can hit him from the weeds, and he can take it in and slam with the best of them, gets the Rabbits on the board.
He's a 13.5 scorer on the season.
He has averaged about 12 points every time he's put on a uniform for South Dakota State. He has started every game since he stepped on campus. Here's Iverson. To Doug Moe will fire. This one's going to be off. Lingenfelder battling for the board, and he stepped out of bounds. Did you see, he tried to bounce the ball off the leg of Iverson, but Iverson just spread his legs, let the ball go right through. So now the Sioux, dressed in their traveling green, of course, as was the women's team. Played in. That ball was off the leg of John Brown and went out of bounds.
Brown didn't want to accept that. He went over and talked to the official, not great length.
Here's Harris, top of the key, working on McDonald. Gets in the lane, puts it up, no good. Big board for Lingenfelder. Outlet Brown, they got a man. It's Winsenburg, under the basket, good.
Nice play for Johnny Brown on the assist. He led well, and Winsenburg took advantage of it, went high, and put it down. Tyatt with 17:15 to play in the half.
That'll say something about the speed of Winsenburg filling that lane. He was out like a shot. Tied at four. Moe gives back to Harris. Jackrabbits starting out in a man-to-man. Actually, they'll leave Lingenfelder primarily in the middle of the lane. Now they get the ball to Harris. He's in trouble in the lane. We'll give it back out front to Moe. Top of the key, good. Doug Moe, perhaps the best outside shooter for the Sioux, at 6'2 and a senior, puts North Dakota on top by a basket at 6'4. Winsenburg, bounce inside, McDonald, back out to Jorgensen, quick move, can't get a shot up. To Winsenburg, for the Sioux playing tight man-to-man. They'll press that offense out as high as they possibly can. Jorgensen on the dribble, guarded by Moe. Rabbits looking to free somebody. They got Winsenburg.
Nice play.
He scoops it up and in. Bob Winsenburg has all six of the Rabbit points, and we're tied again at a half, doesn't he? Working down to the 16-minute mark to go here in the first half. This is Moe. Harris inside. Foul, Winsenburg. Inbounds Moe. Quickly inside, trying to move Bakken. Can't do it. Back out to Moe. They'll leave him open for just a second. That's all the time he needs. 4 points, Doug Moe. 8-6 to Sioux. Jorgensen on the dribble. Comes up high to Lingenfelder. Lingenfelder and Clawson. What a matchup that is. Jorgensen, great move.
Oh!
Well, Jorgensen, his first basket. He has moved into the starting spot that Jim Going held for a long time for the Rabbits.
He took that place when Paul McDonald moved to a forward position.
All right, McDonald can play either. Turn around, Bakken. It will stay. And that was not an easy shot. He had a hand in his face all the way.
So North Dakota out to an early 10-8 lead, but it wouldn't last for long. SDSU flexes its muscle in this 1981 Classic when the Jackrabbit Insider continues.
Underneath Wenzelberg, F. to left header. He rams it home.
Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. For expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. For expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
This portion of the Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it.
Welcome back to the Jackrabbit Insider. As tonight, we look back at a 1981 men's basketball game against North Dakota, not seen since it was originally telecast almost 35 years ago. We rejoin the broadcast with the game not quite 7 minutes old. Once again, Tom Maxwell and Jim Thompson.
12-8, 13-15 to go first half, and the Sioux now in a 2-1-2 with Clawson keeping a special eye on number 5-0. Here's John Brown. Good.
Well, it's tough to stop Johnny Brown from out there. He comes from a good line of outside shooters and has done a super job. He had 18 points the other night in a Rabbit win.
Here's Moe. Took a good long look at it. Didn't take it. Now back to Harris, and the Sioux will be patient with it.
They have not had an easy shot. Only one shot actually in the 6-foot perimeter.
Pocket offensive foul. So the Rabbits will traverse the hard court in search of a tie. Jorgensen in a high right wing. Deep corner, pass, Brown across to Jorgensen. 20-footer, no good. Winsenberg, same motion, got it in. 8 points, Winsenberg off to a good start.
He was all alone.
We're tied at 12. Here's Clawson in the corner. Back out front to Iverson. Neither Lingenfeller or Clawson have scored. Big rolling hook shot from long range. No good by Clawson. Brown out on the dribble. Down to McDonald. Pass in, tipped away. And a foul on Lingenfeller. Sioux play it in. 89-53. They demolished Augustana last night.
Augie did not have a good night, obviously.
Well, he certainly did. Iverson hits it.
That's his first scoring
before,
of the night.
Iverson, the only remnant left of that 76-77 team they had at North Dakota, he played as a freshman. In fact, started for a while as a freshman, then transferred to Wisconsin-Eau Claire. Then came back to North Dakota. Brown, good. Boy, and he gets that shooting eye.
You
there's
notice.
Almost no limitation on his range.
You bet. Now they're going to use him while he's hot. And he has a good chance to be hot for a long time.
14-14. Harris, top of the key. Both teams doing their damage from long range, interestingly enough. Here's Bakken rolling, hooks it up, no good, tip good by Clausen.
Nice play, and that's the first scoring for Dan Clausen.
Oh, he just muscled that one in. Good look at Gene Zulk and his assistant, Gary Espo.
Not been a season that Gene Zulk would like to remember. They've lost, as we said, six of their eight games have been in 10 points or fewer.
And Langenfelder, reverse layup, it's good, the foul is on Bakken. Langenfelder's free throw is good. And the Rabbits have the lead.
That's their first lead of the night.
17-16 with 10:50 to go in the first half. Now the Rabbits will put a little half-court pressure on. Harris is across it. Now tries to weave his way in. Rabbits want to carry the ball call.
Well, he did a good job. Harris did a good job to get rid of the pressure on him.
This is Moe inside Bakken. Working on Lingenfelder. It is offensive. You can tell what the Sioux are trying to do. They're trying to get Lingenfelder in foul trouble.
Yep.
His sponsors at the American School in Turkey were from Larimore, North Dakota. And I imagine they had a hand in his deciding to come to North Dakota to play basketball. McDonald from way outside. Good. That was a three-pointer, folks.
That was a long shot, you bet.
Four of the five starters have scored for the Rabbits, and that is their biggest lead at 3-19-16. And Dave Gunther is up off the bench. He is calling timeout. With 10 minutes and 3 seconds to go in the first half of play, North Dakota led for about the first 9 minutes of the game. Now it's the Rabbits, 19-16.
Mascots, the graphics, how about that music? Ah, this is fun, isn't it? More of this 1981 men's basketball showdown with North Dakota coming up after this week's Jackrabbit Legend.
The SDSU baseball strikeout king, right-hander Adam Bray, is this week's Jackrabbit Legend, presented by Legend Seeds. The Eden Prairie, Minnesota product was a fixture in the rotation during all four seasons in yellow and blue, making a school record 51 career starts. He was 7-2 with a 3.19 ERA as a sophomore. Followed that up with a superb 2.80 earned run average despite a 5-7 record his junior season. And capped off his career with an 8-4 senior campaign and a 2.96 ERA. Three times All-Summit League, Bray struck out 264 batters, obliterating the previous SDSU mark. He also holds a school record with 325 and two-thirds innings pitched. Ace right-hander Adam Bray, a Jackrabbit legend. This Jackrabbit legend is presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader.
Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. For expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Farmers are paying more attention to water quality and making it a priority.
Every farm is different, and every farmer is different. But everyone wants to do what's right for the environment. We're conserving the water, the limited water that we do get, and we're not wasting it.
The individual farmer has to be proactive.
No-till allows our crops to use all the water that we are blessed to receive.
We keep water clean.
For the people of South Dakota, it's about doing the right thing.
I am Al Miron.
Steve Halverson.
Jeff Locker.
This is Farming.
At South Dakota State University, we're not just preparing our students to enter the world, we're preparing them to change it. Because whether it's online, around the state, or around campus, when our students finish their studies here, they'll be ready. ready to care, ready to grow, ready to impact. In fact, we don't wonder if our graduates will be ready for the world. We wonder if the world will be ready for them.
Get ready for the Hefties Fan PhD Tip of the Week, encouraging you to get up, get loud, and get involved, and give the Jackrabbits a hometown advantage.
This year was fantastic. I got my best yields ever.
Record yields start by putting the best seed in the ground. At Hefty, we not only pick the best genetics and traits for you, but we have the most stringent seed grower specs in the industry. That means higher yields for you.
We're Hefties!
And we're big on the farm.
Hefty brand soybeans. Agronomy, answers, yield.
Hey, Jacks fans, we love to have you at the game. We love your involvement. Again, make sure you're positive. Not everybody at the game is an SDSU alum, and so this is our chance to sell who we are and what we're about, so be positive.
This week's fan tip was brought to you by Hefty's Fan PhD, helping Jackrabbit fans go from good to great. The Jackrabbit Insider and this replay of the 1981 men's basketball tilt with North Dakota continues. SDSU took a 36-33 lead into halftime, shooting almost 80% in the opening stanza. And as you saw, they weren't exactly layups. While the Jacks and Mr. Lingenfelter would begin to attack the rim in the second half. And we rejoin the action early in the latter period with SDSU leading 41-38.
John Brown on the dribble gives to Lingenfelter.
Especially if Augustana beats North Dakota State, that would be a big win for whichever team wins here tonight. Would really help their standings in the NCC, obviously.
Underneath, wins it, Burr gives to Lingenfelter, and he rams it home. Steve Lingenfelter with a ram jam makes it 43-38, and wins it, Burr set him up beautifully for that one.
Got everybody off their feet. Steve came sliding in, and Winsenberg puts it right down on him.
And a foul on Winsenberg away from the ball.
Against Clawson, apparently.
Mole goes high in the air to grab that one down. Aaron Harris to Mole again. Underneath, Sonat, rolling hook shot, no good. Clawson with the board, nobody going to stop him. He's going to score.
You've got to almost let him have that, otherwise a three-point play. That's what happened to Lingenfelter on his third foul in that first half.
You saw Lingenfelter just back off as if to say, all right, Big Dan, you got the board, you earned this one. Underneath, McDonald will hook it up. It is good. Well, I have never seen the hook shot in McDonald's repertoire, but there's always a first time.
He's watching Clawson or Sonat. Besides, I can do that one, too.
14 points for McDonald. Underneath, Sonat falls away. No good. Tip try, no good. And Jorgensen comes out of there with it. On the dribble, goes behind the back. Gives to McDonald. Cross-court Winsenberg. He's got time to set up, and he will miss it. Rebound Aaron Harris. The Sioux on a run.
They do.
4-on-3. And we have got an offensive foul on Aaron Harris.
Uh-oh, and he's unhappy about that one.
Boy, you saw his reaction. Now the crowd begins to pick up the clapping chant. Here's John Brown. Took a look at Lingenfelter underneath, decided not to. McDonald will. Good! What a game he's having.
16 points for Pauly.
McDonald's getting them from inside out, free throw line everywhere. 16 for him. He's putting together two great back-to-back nights in crucial games for South Dakota State.
Had 23 last night in that big win over North Dakota State.
Harris will let her fly, no good. He's fouled by McDonald. There's Gene Zolker. Yes, well, we haven't seen him sit down all night, have we?
No. Well, no, I don't think they saved a chair for him. I think he's got a knee pad there.
Harris's free throw is good.
Aaron Harris hit one of the first field goals of the ball game, and that's the first time he's scored since then.
This one is in and out, no good. Now McDonald gives to Winsenberg, up to Jorgensen. They'll let him shoot it. He misses. Jack's a little colder in this second half. Out of bounds, last touch by Brown. So Harris comes up. Sioux trailing by 6. Penetrates, shoots, short, no good. Ball tapped up in the air. Jacks have got a break going. They've got it ahead to John Brown. Jorgensen screens the defense, and Brown scores.
8 points for Johnny Brown.
And an excellent job by Jorgensen to screen the defender away.
Yeah, that can be an assist for Phil, though he never touched the ball. Good job. 14-36 remaining in the game. Jacks by 8, biggest lead of the night.
Doug Moe gets it.
Now, Moe hasn't scored for a while either, Tom, but that's his fourth from off that side.
One very fine shooter is Doug Moe. He won the Clem Littich Hustle Award last year, and he is also a pre-med major.
Brother plays at the Concordia College.
Right. Lingett fell back again! Boy, that was a power stuff! He took the backboard and just took it.
14 points for Steve Lingenfeller. He and McDonald have 30 together.
Nothing can fire up a crowd like a good, strong dunk, and you can smell that one. Shot by Sonod, it won't stay. Whoa, Lingenfeller! Like an avenging angel flying through the lane and pulling the board down. An eight-point lead for the Rabbits. Jorgensen gives to Winsenberg, and he threw it away.
I don't think Lingenfeller was expected to get that, and I don't think Steve was quite ready for it as the pass from Winsenberg was right into the hand of Doug Moe.
Dave Gunther up off the bench saying, slow it down, slow it down. Plofton working on Winsenberg in the lane, puts it up. He
went
to a time in the lane.
The Jacks are up 8 with just under 14 minutes remaining, and we'll see how Gene Zulk's bunch closed this one out when the Jackrabbit Insider returns.
Here's John Brown. Took a look at Lingenfeller underneath, decided not to. McDonald will. Good! What a game he's having.
16 points for Pauling.
At South Dakota State University, we're not just preparing our students to enter the world. We're preparing them to change it. Because whether it's online, around the state, or around campus, when our students finish their studies here, they'll be ready. Ready to care. Ready to grow. Ready to impact. In fact, we don't wonder if our graduates will be ready for the world. We wonder if the world will be ready for them.
To me, sustainability means being able to feed the world in the future.
We need to produce more with less.
It's knowing that our soil is going to be in better shape this year than it was the year before.
We need to stop erosion at the top of the hill, not at the bottom.
We find that we can merge sustainable practices with profitability.
It's about caring for the land.
It's about passing it on to the next generation.
It's about doing the right thing. I have a responsibility.
For the people of South Dakota.
To feed the world.
The future of farming is very bright.
I'm Jeff Lochner.
Steve Halverson.
Al Miron.
This is Farming.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
The Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by the Hefty Seed Company, Agronomy, Answers, Yield. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit northlandford.com or your local dealer. Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it. The University Bookstore. Shop now at jackrabbitcentral.com. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. And by South Dakota State University. Be great. Start here.
Welcome back to this special edition of the Jackrabbit Insider and our look back at the January 24th, 1981 men's basketball game with UND. The visitors climbed to within 4 at the 10-minute mark. So one more time, Tom Maxwell and Jim Thompson.
So now the North Dakota Sioux cheerleaders pick up the chant a little bit across the way. Winsenberg is open. His shot is good. First point of the second half, 10th point of the game for Bob Winsenberg, and Ron Lynch comes bearing news. 5,168 in attendance here in the Port Classic. So not falling away. This time it won't stay. McDonald with a rebound. Thought he was coming with the North Dakota State Aggie score.
Nice play for Jorgensen. He almost lost that one.
Lingenfelder rolling the lane. Good. Lingenfelder with 9 points this half, 16 for the game. 60-52, just past the 10-minute mark. The Sioux with Moe taking a screen from Sonat, shooting no good. Now the Sioux are becoming a little bit cold for the field. Brown leads the fast break, 3-on-2. Jorgensen had Lingenfelder for a moment, and we got what?
Three seconds.
Called on Lingenfelder. Here's Dave Gunther. He was an All-American at the University of Iowa. Team captain, team most valuable player in the late 50s for the great Iowa teams of that period. Harris with a clean shot to the hole,
nice,
and he's got it.
5 points for Aaron Harris, Tom. And again, that's his first field goal since the opening minutes of the contest. He's not gone to the basket well. In fact, he's not really been very evident even defensively.
Jorgensen. Now to McDonald, now to John Brown. He will fire. He will hit it. Well, he began. Bit of a scoring drought for him.
Fourth player to go into double figures for the Jacks, led by McDonald's 19.
Again, the 8-point lead for State, 62-54. The high lob can't hang on. Is Bakken, who checked back in during the timeout. He's not quite warmed up enough yet for that kind of play. Jorgensen took a good long look at that one, decided not to. Now here's McDonald. Look at the double team low on Winsenburg. Now the double team, when the ball comes on this side, will come to Lingenfelder. Double team in the low post.
McDonald looks for somebody in the corner, and Brown will get in there and get it for him.
McDonald will fire. Good! Boy, what a night. What a night. 21 points for McDonald. Still 8.5 minutes to go, and the Rabbits have equaled their biggest lead at 10 points.
Well, you can see I don't know what the capacity is here, but over 5,100 people, and they're all appreciative of the way things are going tonight, no matter whose side they're on.
Aaron Harris misses. Brown with the board. We've got a 4-on-2 fast break. He gets to Jorgensen, and he's good! Jorgensen hits on a beautifully designed fast break. For Bill Jorgensen, it is his 9th point. Biggest lead, a dozen. The crowd will rise to their feet. Dave Gunther will call a timeout.
Things never got any better for the team in green from Grand Forks. Only 5 Jackrabbits scored that day, but all 5 were in double figures. Paul McDonald had 27, Steve Lingenfelter 20, Phil Jorgensen 16, Bob Winsenburg 14, and John Brown 10. As SDSU defeated North Dakota 87-74 on January 24th, 1981. We hope you enjoyed this rebroadcast and that you'll join us next week for another look back at a classic SDSU game. And for all of us here in the Yeager Media Center, I'm Tyler Merriam, and we'll see you next time on the Jackrabbit Insider.